Welcome back to Pathologic Classic HD. We're here at the start of Day 3, and before we actually start Day 3 proper, I've got to go over some things that I just learned about. The first thing I learned about is that it turns out you do actually have a lamp on you. I mean, I've kind of figured there was a lamp in the game, since you do start with kerosene, and it says it's used for refilling the lamp. I just didn't actually know it was actually on me. But it turns out if you press F, you actually have a lamp. So far, it doesn't really seem to matter, though, because I've barely been anywhere that's dark enough to ever really need a light source. So it's not like I was really missing out by not knowing that. But it is there, if I want it. Another thing I learned about is the Plague Finder. I already knew the Plague Finder exists. However, I just kind of forgot about it, and never really had any particular reason to use it. Although I think I'm gonna start having reason to use it, since the plague is obviously spreading. And another thing I learned about it is that the lens that I have, that I got from Lara Ravel, the lens that she gave me is actually used to upgrade it. So if you look at this little bar up here, it's got like one bar filled. If I use the lens, now it's got three bars filled. Does that mean the Plague Finder has longer range or more accuracy or something? I don't know, but I guess I imbetterfied it. And the third and probably most important thing is letters. As it turns out, as people told me in the comments for the first episode of the series, yes, I recorded a lot of episodes of Pathologic, so even though I'm recording episode 10, episode 1 of Pathologic just went up, so I was reading comments for that and people were telling me that throughout the game you actually get letters and you can read them. And they're very important letters, as it turns out. It turns out they kind of tell you, like when you start the day, they sort of tell you things like who you should go visit when you start the day. Man, that would have been really useful a while ago, huh? That would have been super useful. I guess the only indication that you've actually been sent a letter is just some esoteric signal, symbol that appears at the corner of the screen, sort of like the symbol that appears when your journal gets updated. It's not very clear, but now I know, and that's the important part. So before we get to the day proper, let's catch up on the important stuff that we've missed. There's tabs here for each day. Obviously, we've been through day 1 and 2, and we've just started day 3. So, this is probably going to take a while, but we still need to get caught up. It's important, so let's do it. The very first letter I was ever sent at the beginning, on day 1. The letter from the powers that be. Bachelor Dankovsky. By what seems to be a very lucky coincidence, you have found yourself in a town that is wrought by some very worrying occurrences. Reportedly, there is an outbreak of dangerous disease in the vicinity. There's also an opinion that the outbreak is a falsification staged deliberately for the purpose of concealing a murder. In consideration of your outstanding analytical capability, we delegate the investigation to you. If there is an epidemic, it must be halted by any means necessary. You should collect as much information as you can, we suppose, and then make a decision in line with your own professional ethics and moral beliefs. In order to implement your strategy, an inquisitor endowed with unrestricted authority will shortly arrive to join you. In the event that you are unable to curb the outbreak before their arrival, all power over the situation will be reassigned to them. P.S. It has come to our attention that you have recently requested permission to continue with your own research. The decision of whether or not such permission will be granted depends on the results of this assignment. Your success, therefore, has a bearing on your scientific reputation and your further academic career. Professor Tellman. Yeah, so I really do have to do this right, otherwise the powers that be will take away my scientific standing. My ability to do research, basically. The body's isolated. Okay, so that's just a little message from Alexander Superov, completely irrelevant at this point, just saying to stop on by, blah blah blah. A letter from a colleague in Fanatica. Daniel, I'm writing this in a hurry, so do forgive the uncustomary brevity. The powers that be are closing in on us. They persecuted us before, as you know, but now they are set to utterly exterminate us. We may yet be able to persevere, but you, my friend, are in grave danger. It is almost as if your destination was chosen to be the place of your burial. They say there is some kind of disease in the town, of a most lethal variety, perhaps plague itself. I have little doubt that the powers that be have set up your whole journey. Tellman, that vermin, wants to get rid of you more than he wants to cease the outbreak. I wouldn't be surprised if it transpires that there are no medical personnel whatsoever in the town. They will use it as a pretext to delegate the whole mess of it to you. If this is the case, I urge you to keep out of trouble. Stay safe, Daniel. Wait for the sanitary teams. They will arrive sooner or later. Take care, my friend. If they tell you to engage the plague by yourself, refuse it, even if your principals enjoin you to do otherwise. Our research is what matters the most, and we will not be able to go on with it if you are dead. Yours, A. Wow. Even going, they're telling me to go against my medical principles to do good and to help people, just for the sake of the research. Not only can I not do that, I've already chosen not to do that. It's too late, although it wouldn't have made any difference. Isidore Barak's message. My dear Bachelor Denkovsky, it was most disconcerting to learn that the powers that be have the intention of shutting down the laboratory that owes its fame largely to your own research in the field of thanatology. Is it true that your detractors have branded your studies scientifically stillborn? Rejoice, Bachelor, for there is an observable case that would quell the obscurants that reject the research of death, aging, and necrosis as a subject that lacks academic viability. This case, were you to document it, would go a long way towards restoring your reputation as a scholar. The subject in question is Simon Kane, who has ruled the town where I live for as long as I remember. This man's longevity transcends the boundaries of what is plausible. It is phenomenal, no less, and I struggle to give an explanation of it with what scientific means I have at my disposal. Make no delay. There is a sensational discovery to be made here, a breakthrough that will not only save your laboratory, but also revivify your studies and greatly increase your scientific renown. Your humble servant and faithful colleague, Isidore Barak. P.S. I spoke to Simon on your behalf, and he has kindly agreed to facilitate your effort. Daring ideas and far-fetched projects are traditionally very well respected in our neck of the woods. Far-fetched projects, indeed, I've heard about. Projects. The Bull Project, or whatever that thing was called. Okay, day two. The evening letter from the powers that be, day two. To facilitate your assignment, we will be sending a special train carrying medicine, sanitary equipment, and personnel. We expect the train to arrive in 4 days. The Inquisitor, allegedly Mark Karminsky or Peter Croy, will travel separately. If the sanitary train reaches the town before the Inquisitor, the personnel and equipment therein will be yours to manage. The person in charge of the sanitary expedition will be duly instructed to collaborate. We hope that by that time you'll have exhaustive information as to what the nature of the disease is. Sent on behalf of the Manipulatory Laboratory. What a name for a laboratory. Manipulatory Laboratory. Lara Rival's invitation. That's just her asking me to come by and help her. Already done. Subarov's morning note. Subarov just reminded me to come by. I've already done that, so no point in reading that. Okay. Alright, we're caught up now. So now day three, that is the day that we're on. A worrying message from Georgie Kane. Please visit me at the Crucible at your earliest convenience. Another misfortune has befallen us. And again, it concerns the person whom you have traveled so far to see. I hope the woes of our family are still of some importance to you. Kane. Okay, yeah, so these letters, these notes, and letters that I've been receiving are super important, not only because they give me more backstory, but also because they tell me things like, oh, the first person I should visit for the day is Georgie Kane. And also, this one says that there's train carrying all sorts of equipment coming in 4 days, which would be day 3, 4, 5, 6, and we're on day 3, so 3 days from now this train should come. That is very important to know. All right, I think we're all cut up. Let's see if Ava has anything new to say.
What is there to talk about now?
I'd rather you didn't miss assistance you can offer is not taking risks. Okay, yeah, nothing new to say. She just wants to help me, and she can't really help me in any way. Unless you have some food. If you have some food somewhere, that would actually really, really help, because I'm very close to starving.
I'm having chest pain.
Yeah, I was also told, by the way, that every NPC, you know how they have a little bit of audio dialogue that they say if you're just around them, or if you initiate a conversation like this?
There'll be no deaths while you're with us, right?
Apparently, the little audio bits that come from every NPC actually change with each day. That's what people were telling me, so I think I'm going to make sure to initiate the conversation multiple times for every NPC just to make sure I hear everything they have to say.
I've seen the Angel of Death by the window.
What time is it? I haven't spent too much time dawdling and reading in here, so no need to reload my save. Georgie, Georgie, Georgie. But first, since I feel like I have all the time in the world, which is probably a very bad belief to have, but I feel like it, I'm gonna loot every bin I see. Also gotta make sure to speak with the kids, because I really need to trade for more ammunition for my revolver. Ooh, razor, nice. Oh my god, pocket watch! I've got 5 pocket watches, I could trade for so many things! Plus, I just got those nuts from Lara Ravel. Hey kids, you got the goods? Let me see. Oh yeah, and I think people were also telling me that there's unique dialogue. Like unique text dialogue with the less important NPCs like her and all the other NPCs like that you know aren't the main characters. There's unique dialogue with them every day apparently. Like, you're so pale, I think that's new, isn't it? I'm dying for a gulp of milk, but they won't let us milk the cows. Do you by any chance have some? Who doesn't let you milk cows? Well, people say that cows have been oozing some ichor instead of milk lately. Auntie said she knows this for sure, and Mom nodded and added that Aga, the cook, agrees. And she's a stepwoman and all. She knows everything about cows. Aga even went as far as to say that the milk turned completely black. She's right. Doesn't sound like you should drink such milk. I'll check on your cows or assign this task to someone. I don't think I am gonna check on the cows, because I don't even know where the cows are. I've never even seen an animal, actually. I've heard dogs bark, but I've never seen a dog, which is creepy, if you think about it. Nothing to trade. Lame. Is everything all right with you, you little rapscallion? A neighbor of ours has been killed by patrolmen. I still can't wrap my head around it. That means they can make away with me just as easily. And with you, too. What did they kill him for? Well, they said he attacked someone, too. He did have quite a temper. But they beat him to death with their mega fists. What? By the way, was there really an order to do that? For reals? How do we fight now? How do we defend our honor? I'm sorry, boy. Can we just back up to the point where you said they beat him to death with their mega fists? That sounds absurd. Is that a joke? Mega fists? Did it make like comic book sounds as they beat him to death? Like, kapow! The order was issued to put a stop to the chaos. Pfft, right. Good luck with that. You keep in mind that we can stand up for ourselves just fine. If anyone hurts me, my Dinah, or any of my friends, or Capella, they'll be in big, big trouble. My fists are in the right place too, you know? Got it? But do you have mega fists? Why are you shouting at me? Do I look like a patrolman? Did I try to trade with you? No, I didn't. Ah, yes, please give me one of those. One needle for one round. Gladly. Which one is Georgian? This one? Yeah. Alright, Georgie, what happened? Let me guess. I'm going to guess, because of what you said about Reuben, that Reuben has probably died examining Simon's body.
Olginsky has put a bounty on any runaway butcher. What is the old fox trying to hide?
Runaway butcher. That'd be Worm, right? Wait. No, I'm trying to remember. Is Worm a butcher or a herder? No, the butchers are the ones that can't talk and just like scream and stuff, right? The one that tried to punch me in the basement when I went to talk to them? That's the butchers, right? Not the worm creatures? Aren't those the cattle herders? The worm creatures? Anyway. My dear doctor, misfortune is a regular guest in our family home. A new calamity has befallen us. It's gotta be Reuben. What is it? The house in which Reuben lived and worked has been tainted by infectious mold and fallen prey to the looters. Our messengers searched every nook and cranny. Neither Reuben nor Simon's body are in the house. Some of the people that helped to undertake the search are paying a terrible price. They've contracted the sand pest. Oh, great. How would you explain the absence of the body? It appears that once the infection began to spread across the house, Master Reuben decided to remove the body. He must have taken it to some hidden location that he considered safe. However, since we still haven't heard from him, we can only infer that Reuben is dead. Sounds likely. Let's hope that Reuben will get in touch soon. Something tells me that isn't going to happen. Were you going to ask me for help? Please help us recover the body, Doctor. We are already much indebted to you for having identified Simon's killer. It's not your fault that the truth has turned out to be so distressing to us all. I implore you to help Simon, and us, once more. Find my brother's body. The task is far from trivial. Where do I even start? Someone may have seen something. I believe you've made some useful acquaintances in the town's slums. Not to mention we have all manner of lowlife here. Could they know something? Speak to my brother Victor. He is much better than me where the practical side of things is concerned. I'll let you know what I find. So just to check, that symbol and that sound of scribbling, that's just my journal being updated, right? Not a new note? Yeah, it's just telling me to go to Victor, because of the body. So there's no new note, right? Yep, no new note, okay. Wanna make sure I don't- whoa. Another scribbling. Is that a note? Where did the second scribbling come from? Double scribble. It makes me uncomfortable. It is a bad omen indeed when there are two scribbles but only one quest update. Tell me, Victor, what do you know about the double scribble?
The true way to be deceived is to think oneself more knowing than others.
I'm looking for your brother's body, Victor. Do you have any ideas on the subject? I do. If I were you, Olginsky's son would be the first person I'd turn to. Young Vlad, nicknamed... Is it Sharon? Charon? Sharon? Char? I'm just gonna call you Young Vlad, or Baby Vlad, or Tiny Vlad. Ruben and he had some business together. He knows places where Ruben may have taken the body. Have you already asked him? I've tried, but we are in a difficult position now. On the one hand, we are putting pressure on his father. On the other, we're asking him for a favor. Why did he deny you help? Vlad the Younger is a loyal son. He may be cynical, but deep inside he believes in the precepts of vassal ethics. He has no reason to conceal a crime, but he'd never help us knowing that we're acting against his father's best interests, notwithstanding our respect for each other. Tell everyone in your household to remain indoors. If anyone had to be sent outside, don't let them back in. What? Abandoning them in the middle of the perilous night? No. Such people have to go to the isolation ward first. Zubarov promised me that the ward will be set up soon. See if he has anything more to say.
Is this disease indeed as deadly as they say?
Yes. Yes, it is.
What?
That is an awesome bit of dialogue.
Is this disease indeed... is buzzing in my ears.
Do you know anything regarding Ruben's whereabouts? It's weird that that's like a separate question, because I kind of already asked him about that. The disappearance of Master Ruben fills me with sincerest regret. He is, of course, the person most to blame for the loss of our brother's remains, but that's not what matters. And what is? We have no competent people left except you. We are unable to put up a struggle. Is it true what I've been told? That you declined Subarov's request and did not accept responsibility for the town's future? Who told you such nonsense? Not only did I agree, I explicitly stated my eagerness to do all that is within my power. You are a noble man, Bachelor Dankovsky. So we do still have a hope. That's my duty towards the powers that be. No, I'm not doing this for the powers that be. I'm doing this because I'm a man of principle, right? Yeah. Am I? I mean, I don't know. Am I trying to roleplay the Bachelor, or am I trying to roleplay myself? You know what I mean? Because if I'm trying to roleplay myself, then I want to be a man of principle, but if I'm trying to roleplay the Bachelor, I feel like I'm doing this for the sake of our research, trying to get the powers that be off our back. I really don't know. I'm acting in accordance with my beliefs. So we must speak with Younger Vlad. You know what, while I'm here, I might as well go speak to Maria. Don't know if there's ever really any point in speaking with somebody without having a quest to go see them specifically. But just in case. No big deal, just pop over.
There's more life in me that can be lived.
Nope, didn't seem like it.
What is this disease? Yes.
Okay, nothing particularly interesting from her voice. Her voices for today. I need to do a lot of trading. I really do need to do a lot of trading. I also need to find food. Let's head to Younger Vlad. Yeah, I guess let's just go. Stop any kids along the way, have conversations with any new people. Apparently the unique conversations that you can have with the relatively unimportant NPCs, the unique ones for each day, apparently that's divided by... it's divided by class? Because if you notice, like, everybody's clones, basically. you know, there's like the little girl and then the bigger girl, and then there's like the little boy and then the bigger boy, and like there's that class of guy over there with like the fancy clothes on. Apparently the unique dialogue is always the same for people of one class, so like these two people here will both have exactly the same dialogue. Good morals and luck are a great help in managing small community without resorting to violence. Personal standing can work wonders. Sorry, I can't help feasting my eyes on your outfit. Who was the mad tailor? I think I offended him. He's like, good day, sir. 10 o'clock? Yep, 10 in the morning. Plenty of time, right? There's always plenty of time. I'm just gonna take off and explore for 5 hours. Nothing wrong with that at all. I've got so many tradables. Come here, youths. Give me bullets. And drugs. Especially drugs. Ooh, yes, drugs, please. Look at how many tradables I have. This is obscene. Perfect. Oh wait, no, not perfect. I want the other two of these. Do I have anything worth 4? A knife is worth 5. There we go. And I think I'm gonna take the pills, actually, to get my immunity up. My infection's still going up, and my immunity's not maxed, so yeah, let's take them. There, now my immunity is very, very high. Don't need another lockpick, don't need the other kind of ammo. Oh, I haven't spoken to your class type yet. Oh, still nothing to say to you. Weird. And you, boy, do you want to trade with my nuts? That sounds really lewd, but seriously, like, I mean that literally. I have nuts to trade. Yes, that's what I remember trying to figure out what this boy wanted. I had, like, nothing for him, almost. Apparently he really likes peanuts, hazelnuts, and walnuts. Let's keep the nuts for now. I guess I'll just trade the razors. No, if the boy is the only one who actually takes the nuts, then I think I can trade the razor with other kids, but I can only trade the nuts with the boy, it seems like, so I guess I should actually trade the nuts. All the things I'm saying right now sound really lewd, but seriously, they're not meant to be. Please don't run away, please don't run away. I'm just reloading. Don't run. Oh. Well, not gonna be trading with her. Maybe she likes to trade with the nuts too. Yeah, they do. Okay, so the very young girl and the very young boy both trade with nuts. Although she also likes flowers too. And she's got nothing to trade. You know what? I want to brighten her day. There. I just gave her the flower for nothing. Just, you know, to cheer her up. It's fine. Just bring a little bit of light into the world. Let's make somebody happy. It's a grim world. Let's do something good. It's fine. One needle for one more round. Don't mind me, I'm just gonna hide in a corner and reload my pistol. Okay, how much ammo do I have? Do I have ammo spilling over? I don't. All of it's in my gun, which means at most I have 6 rounds. Because that's all that can fit in the pistol. Where am I going? I'm going the wrong way. Young Vlad. Baby Vlad. Tiny Vlad. Mini Vlad. Boy! I'm on the prowl for children to trade with. That sounds messed up, but seriously, like, I need to trade for stuff. I've got lots of trading goods, but not a lot of actual goods. Oh, yes. More ammo. Thank you. Can't reload, so I guess it's full. Okay, so I've got six in there, and then two more outside, so I've got eight shots in total. Six in the chambers. So much water. Lockpick? Nah.
It's all very suspicious.
Rubens disappeared. His home has been infected and looted. Neither his body nor Simon's was there. Where could he have gone? I don't know. I haven't seen him. Do you suspect that Ruben is dead? I do. Well, if neither Reuben nor Simon were in the dead house, that means Reuben has at least attempted to move the Keeper's body to another place. Otherwise, we would have to surmise that someone has stolen two infected bodies with peculiarly obscure purposes. Wouldn't you agree? You're reading my mind. I find it hard to believe that the body's been stolen. No madman could ransom it to the Canes and get away alive. And you could never find the kind of blasphemer who would defile it out of sheer malice. Reuben will make himself known soon, you'll see. And still, I beg for your assistance. There's no doubt in my mind that you have a theory of your own. Look, Reuben's dealings with our family is our family's business. We value his trust. I don't feel that disclosing the details to you would be the right thing to do. Not unless I see that... The family would benefit more than it would suffer from that exchange. Do you understand? Yes. You want to come out ahead. You want to gain money and not lose money by giving me information. And you feel like you'd lose money if you gave me this information. I get it. I want to settle the dispute between us and the Canes concerning our unwillingness to let emissaries into the termitary. I don't know what the Canes are thinking. We are not harboring anything or anyone there that could be of even remote interest to them, especially to my deeply esteemed fellow Victor. So why don't you let the inspectors in, then? First of all, it's dangerous. The rabble is rioting. I've told you about that more than once already. Secondly, Father will not submit to the younger Cain's orders. If this keeps up, we'll soon be taking orders from his 10-year-old son. I'm doing this not on the Canes' orders, but at their request. And I act on my authority, not theirs. Sounds elaborate. Very well then. I'll give you one more reason to keep the termitary closed for as long as possible. Frankly speaking, it's you who should have prohibited us from letting anyone in there. Even yourself. It's your direct duty. You mean quarantining the place? Exactly. Fortunately, we locked the termitary off a day before the sand dirt came to our town. Should the Canes insist, I have an argument that will easily convince both them and you. You require proof of the veracity of my words, too, don't you? I'm listening. The Canes are hiding something, too. They have their own skeleton in the closet. and it's even more unsightly than ours. Our closet is full of our own workers. Theirs is full of other people's children. If you can make sure that everything is well inside the polyhedron, then trust me, the termitary is fine too. It's an enclave, a closed chamber. Wait. So, if I'm not misreading Vlad the Younger, he's saying that the termitary is the Olgimsky's closet. But they're also, he's also saying that the polyhedron is the Kane's closet. The Kane's have never mentioned anything about the polyhedron ever, have they? Have they even mentioned its name? I don't believe so. If so, then this is very, very strange, because the Olgimskys have never, you know, they've never lied or done anything to suggest that they, you know, don't own and operate the termitary and all that stuff. Obviously, that's their thing. But the Kanes have never even mentioned the polyhedron, so I wonder if they're trying to hide something about it. What the hell is the polyhedron, and what do the Kanes have to do with it? Was the polyhedron closed after the termitary? And it was much closer to the original source of the plague, to Simon Kane. Sounds convincing. I'll inspect the polyhedron and talk to Victor, but I'll ask a favor of you in return. Help me find Simon's body. Try to curb the righteous anger of the judge and the terrible Victor. They seem to have finally decided to harass my father to death. I have no doubt that no matter what he did, it's not his fault. If you do that, I will gladly assist you. Okay, so get them to stop harassing older Vlad, and he'll help me find Simon's body. Okay. Deal. Fair enough. Okay, just keep making sure I didn't receive more letters. Nope. So the body of the immortal is in other tasks, so I guess that means it's optional. Wow, I still don't have a main quest for today, it looks like. Yeah, so I need to go speak with the Kanes, see if I can get them to stop harassing older Vlad, and also see if I can inspect the polyhedron. Also, I need food, because I'm literally, like, about to start starving to death. I need food right now. Let's go to Lara Ravel's house. Let's see if she'll provide me with food. If not, then there's two food shops right around her place. Am I the only one that finds it super creepy that you hear dogs barking all the time, but you never see a single dog ever? That's just weird. It's really weird. I just realized there's actually multiple of these floating buildings. There's another one, in the other direction. Huh. What have you got? Oh, one more round. One needle for one of those. Thank you. That means I have 9 shots for my revolver. Yeah, and I gotta do my trading in the day with the children, because at night they go inside. So many children. It's wonderful. Hmm. I'll take some more medicine, sure. Ooh. Even more rounds, yes please. That means I have 11 shots for the revolver, I believe. Oh god. It's you again. Have a rest. That's the same conversation as before. Okay, up a bit to the left and then to the right, and I'll be at Lara Ravel's place. More drugs. Okay, there goes all my nuts. Oh, what time is it? 11 a.m., plenty of time. Ooh, double ding, again. Creepy. So much water. I'm drowning in water. In fact, I've got so much water, maybe I should just get a bandage. Oh, you don't even have a bandage. Do you have anything to say? What's the news around town? Vanity of vanities. All is vanity. Take the polyhedron. That's become a children's game now. 'Tis lovely children that reside there now. They've weaved a nest among the deadly tines of the machine, like charming singing birds. But not for them the tower's been conceived, but for the glory of the benefactors, the family of them philanthropists. They're doing it for the glory of the benefactors. Are they talking about the Canes? What family are you talking about? The Canes, yes, so the polyhedron is connected to the Canes. The Canes, stricken down with bitter grief these days. Who else? For 'twas another purpose that their project was intended for. The purpose without notice having lost. It stands abandoned now, and so it will until the end of days. You know, for a guy that appears to be drunk and also kind of, like, maniacal, his words are almost like poetry or something. What was it intended for? Damned if I know. Not for the mortal life that's filled with honest sweat, with mundane pain, and transient jealousy. There was a lofty purpose that is unknown to me. A purpose unfulfilled. A dream, yes sir. Okay, tell me, is any of your mates sick with strange disease? Our souls are sick. Mine, and those of my friends. A sickness both contagious and lethal. The sickness unto death. Thanks. Ooh. Oh, she's got a lot of alpha tablets. Oh, but I have nothing, literally nothing to trade with her. If I still had the flower, I could get more alpha tablets. But no, I don't regret giving that little girl the flower. She deserved it. Excuse me, sir. Oh, nothing to say. Fine, then. Rude. I'm, like, literally about to be dying of hunger. Lara!
What?
Are you tired? Hungry? Quite. You've heard already that all the provisions been destroyed, right?
What? No?
Actually, that doesn't say all the provisions been destroyed. This says all the provisions be destroyed? Anyway. They say it was the infected meat that caused the disease. So now there's no food at all. Only the food we've managed to snatch before it all began. So I have nothing to offer. save for some bread and milk. I'll take that, gladly. I can tell her to save it. But I'm not gonna be some, like, super selfless person here. Let's be honest, I am literally about to starve to death. I need the food. Milk and bread are not that bad. Oh my god, thank you so much. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. God, what they said about the milk and the ichor and the blood clots and— oh god, I really don't want to drink it.
What?
I think I have to, and it didn't make my infection bar or anything like that go up, so I guess it's okay. Okay, that milk sure didn't do much, but... Just the thought of that milk makes me want to vomit. Is my health going down? Has it been going down? Or is that just what it's been at all day? I don't know. Whatever, it's high enough. I'm not about to kill over dead, so I'll live with it. Right, so I need to go speak with Victor. Well, I think I'll save that for the next episode. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far. And when I return, I'm gonna go speak with Victor and see if I can convince him to stop harassing the older Olgimsky so that I can get the younger Olgimsky to help me find Simon's body.